Yes. The rock that I selected with the address sign on it for the landscape out here at Stinson Beach that I installed 20-something years ago matches exactly the bark of the Arbutus marina. Look at that. So, Arbutus marina, super beautiful tree. It has this wonderful red bark that peels off, and it's called the garden madrone by many. And the reason it's called the garden madrone is the Pacific madrone, which is so beautiful and native in this area. In fact, it's the most latitudinal ranging tree in the world. We'll do a whole video on that from all the way down in San Diego Mountains, all the way up to British Columbia. But anyway, this is, so the Pacific madrone is really difficult to grow. It gets a fungus in the ground if you water it in the summertime, and most gardens get water in the summer, and so it rots. But this tree here looks a lot like the Pacific madrone. It has nice evergreen foliage, not quite as big or as glossy or as rounded as the Pacific madrone, but still beautiful nonetheless and evergreen. But the key difference between this plant and the true California madrone is the fact that this plant can handle garden conditions so much better, and that's why it's called the garden madrone. Now, here is the flower on the garden madrone. Super beautiful, beautiful pink draping down. And like I said, it's evergreen. The younger branches are always rather smooth, smooth barked. It's a fantastic tree to use. It's a fairly small scale tree for a while, but it can actually get pretty big. And I have a good buddy who can attest to that because he has the largest garden madrone, certainly in California. And I'll throw him out there. Randy Baldwin, super horticultural legend. If you know that guy, you'll know what I'm talking about. If you don't know that guy, you should know this guy because he's pretty legendary. He's done a lot of amazing things. And anyway, in his garden down in Santa Barbara, he has one that's 53 feet across. Okay, this one here is probably 25 feet across. And so his is just absolutely amazing. Anyway, so there you go, Randy. Sorry for spilling the beans on you. But anyway, don't stalk Randy. Yeah, he doesn't need any more stalkers. He's already got enough. But maybe someday you'll get to see his garden, see his madrone, and you'll know that I was not lying. So anyway, let's look at this tree. Beautiful dark green foliage. There's a really interesting story about how this tree came to be, especially this particular tree. So Arbutus marina is a naturally occurring hybrid in Europe. This is a really good case for continental drift and the super continent of Gondwana. And the whole idea is that there used to be one giant continent and it split apart and it started drifting all over. Well, that would be the only way you could really explain the fact that you have a Pacific madrone here in North America. Here's one of the fruits. You actually eat the fruit. It's not that good. It's a little seedy, but it's okay if you're really desperate. But the continental drift theory states that all these continents broke apart and they drifted apart. And next thing you know, you've got multiple continents, but you have very similar plants in the same family on separate continents where there's no way a bird could carry a seed across an ocean. So the only thing that can really explain it, I think, would be continental drift. So anyway, this tree, this particular tree in California was found in one garden in San Francisco and in a guy's garden, and it was taken as a cutting by the Saratoga Horticultural Research Foundation in 1984. I came to find this tree in about 1989 when I was at that nursery. They kind of went under. Look how beautiful the bark is on this thing. But anyway, the story keeps going and further back in time. And the guy that had the tree in front of his house in San Francisco, which is no longer there, it finally blew over. He got his cutting from Stribing Arboretum in San Francisco. And that cutting came from a boxed tree that was used from the Pan American Exposition from a plant from Western Nursery that went out of business. And their plant came apparently from cuttings that were taken in Italy, where this tree occurs as a natural hybrid. That's the story, they think, but they're not totally sure. Anyway, it's a fantastic tree to use in gardens. It becomes totally drought tolerant with age, like many other trees, and it's moderately drought tolerant when it's young. The wonderful thing about it is the bark, obviously, and the fact that it's evergreen. And here, this is a coastal location, and trees typically grow sideways, if at all, here because of the oceanic winds. This tree can handle fairly strong winds and on the ocean and be fine with it. But the most beautiful part about this tree, it can be grown as a standard, meaning like a lollipop shape, street tree style, or a beautiful multi-trunk, which is how we allow this one to grow. So now you know, Arbutus marina, wonderful tree to use. You'll have that beautiful bark.